passes me.
Lamy bowls to Lizelle Lee. Can cut short another misfield in the field and cover. And will cost Thailand two runs. As they do come back for the second, Saturang couldn't pick it up. So a couple more for Lizelle Lee. She's 93.
It's been a great little partnership, hasn't it? And it's probably at the point where they're both going to probably start looking for boundaries, and I think that's where we'll see a bit of an increase in the run rate.
Well, South Africa was 1 for 13, now 1 for 136. Lee 93 off 56. Wait for Laomi. It's a sweep. A shout for LBW. Not out is the call. And Lizzie frustrated. Lizelle Lee frustrated down on one knee. Still, she missed out of the ball. Trickled away on the offside. It remains 136. For one in the 16th over.
It was a little bit early, but there's no way knowing that the girl be. That's hit her in the shoulder, Murray.
Yeah, it was a tentative shout. Lamb goes well short, pulled away by Lizelle Lee. That may race away for four. Coming around desperately was Chaiwai, but it beats her to the boundary rope. 97 Lizelle Lee. South Africa 1 for 140, the 15th four for the South African opener, along with three sixes. South Africa in its first five overs scored 32, second five scored 48, and then 50 off the third five.
Well, don't go away, because it's going to be the next two balls, Maury, whether it's a four or a six.
I'm staying here. I'm staying right here with you, Brockton. Now, there's a long off. There's almost two long offs. There's a sort of deep extra cover, long on and a deep mid wicket. As Lizelle goes on the sweep, it goes backward a square. It's going to go for four, and that's going to be 100. It is, for the first time in South African colours in T20 cricket. Lizelle Lee gets a century. 101 from 59 deliveries. South Africa 1 for 144. She scored 101 out of 144. The 100 from 59 deliveries.
It is that lack of concentration. It's got to be, you're pumped up, you're ready to explode, and then all of a sudden, you're giving a softer swivel.
So, Chloe Tryon's out there now, the 26-year-old from Durban. She has a strike rate of 138.31 in her 62 previous games. High score of 43, scored 12 against England. Got out just before the winning run was scored the other night. Lizelle Lee, 101, 60 deliveries, 16 fours, 3 sixes. And now we're to start the 17th over of the innings. It's a shocking delivery by Tipok, and it's belted away, a full toss down leg side, past the short fine leg for four. Sune Luus quietly going about her business, but she's 42 off 31. Yeah, and it's 2 for 148.
she's contributed really well to that partnership and gave Lizelle a lot of strike. And now it's her turn. It's her turn to get on with the business. And I'm sure Chloe Tryon won't take too long to get into the game as well.
So Tipok, the captain. In again to Luus, who is sweeping powerfully between beat square leg and short fine leg for another four. That raced away. Two for 150. So the wicket actually fell at 144 to make it a 131-run partnership between Lee and Lee and Luus. And now Sune Luus is just picking up where Lizelle Lee left off.
Yeah, just that length, like just going to get this, this length right. And obviously the line as well. It's just way down leg there where you haven't got that protection on the boundary there.
22 balls for the last 50 for South Africa. Tip off. Old Sue Luus, who gives herself room, pulls a short delivery away to take some wickets, and there'll be only a single design as the anchor set field. And Luus moves to 47 on 33, to 153 on the 17th total.
Here we have Chloe Tryon, and we, you know, in WBBL, you never had a low shoot batting into the Hurricanes and part of the back.
Tip off, rolls and sign. She is an all or nothing player. This time she punches it down towards long on. We'll only get one. She jogged through, but there was no chance of the second run in any case. And doing good work was Koncharoenkai from the long on boundary. So Tryon's off the mark. South Africa, so well played, as you'd expect them to be against Thailand. Tip off it is. Bowling to Luus is on the sweep this time towards deep square leg, all the way along the ground. You'll get but one as the fielding is done out there by Boochatham. And Luus moves to 48, 155 for two. One ball left in the 17th over.
That's definitely a better line and length for the field that she's sort of got there. And that's the way you can sort of, you know, if you, Thailand just need to try and bowl as many dots and ones as they can.
Tipok now to Tryon, who got a great save by Tipok, the bowler, diving to a right. I assume that was going to run down long on, but that time a run saved by the captain, Tipok, who has one ball to come in her second over. In fact, no, that's the end of the over. She has none for 15. With South Africa, two for 155. So there were 14 runs off the 16th over, and now 11 off the 17th. I'll give you a figure, and you give me an over or under from here. 155, I'll say 190.
I'm going to say 195. I think Chloe's going to take off here and I think Luus is going to go with her. Chloe's going to crowd it, she's going to crowd it, and you know what, she actually gets out. Mignon and Preez is sitting on the bench too, and we saw her hit one for six. We've got them over the line against England, so biggest six of the lot. Mignon and Preez, so three overs left. We'll be Boochatham to come
on for the first time from this broadcast in the Manukau into the ground. She hasn't had a great time, but two overs to 25. So that brings two for 155. Luus, 48. Wait, and this is a well-flighted ball top. Hammered over square leg for six, and Sune Luus brings up a half century for South Africa. That was a rank full toss. And Luus just whacked it over the square leg boundary to bring up her 50. And it comes up from 35 balls, so the same pace as Lizelle Lee, 5 fours and 2 sixes.
It's a great little innings, and you know, obviously you get a full toss and it's a gimme. You want it to be a six in the last three overs of a game, especially when you've only lost the 2 wickets. So, you know, just a great partnership that she had with Lizelle Lee, and she'll be hoping to finish this off with Tryon.
Boochatham bowls are off spinners. It's clubbed down the ground towards long off this time. Out of this field. Coming there, doesn't put them wrong from 10 to 2. They do just get the run, so Luus to 55 off 36. South Africa 162 for 2. Already this partnership with 18. Chloe Tryon's only got one of them. She's only faced a couple of balls, and she's tapping a bat with a deep square, deep mid wicket, and a long on in place, plus a long off. And this one, she drives down towards long off. Another fumble there by Kim Champu, but again, it doesn't cost a run. Just a single. Tryon to two. Two for 163 in the 18th.
Yeah, they've really got that onside field with the mid-off out, so they want to bowl in at the body here, don't they? Nothing outside off. No room where they can hit you over cover.
Boochatham bowls a bit short of a length, and it's swept away by Luus. Beats the infield. Coming across towards deep backward square. Thailand has some coverage, so they only get two runs instead of a boundary. Once it beat the infield, you didn't think it might have been a four, but they get two. Lose for 57.
It just took off. Like it was almost like it was going down a hill there.
This outfield batter, so good. You do get bad with it.
You want to be a batter.
Sune Luus has a high score of 71. She's currently on 57. She waits for Boochatham. Well quiet and trapped down the ground, but along the ground a bit off. And Chetty feels cleanly this time. Gets the return back into the bowl of Boochatham for a run. Sune Luus 58. So they'll get two for 166. 11 off this over so far. Where's she looking? Cow corner or straight?
Maybe straight.
Back comes Boochatham, mouthful of the over, and she whacks it away between square leg and mid-wicket. This wicket's got it covered, and it's fielded well in the end, that try by Chaiwai. So they only get a run, try and hit the strike, 2-3. End of the 18th over, 2 for 167, Luus 58, Tryon not out on 3, so a dozen runs coming off that over. So since the 15th over, we've seen 14, 11 and 12 come respectively. This group so wide open, this win today, if South Africa does in fact go on to win it, will take them at least temporarily to the top of the table with a very good net run rate, you would think, building up here. But then England and Pakistan tonight starts at 8 o'clock English time, 7 o'clock local time. We'll be on here from 6:45 local time as Tipok now bowls a full toss. Tryon goes square, high, long, six. And that was another full toss, this time from Tipok. And try and belted it away in front of the Sir Donald Bradman stand to move to 9. South Africa 2 for 173 in the 19th.
Yeah, you really feel for Tipok there. You know, it's you bowl a full toss at this period of the game, you know you're probably going to be watching it sail over the boundary. I like the fact she wants to bowl a little bit smaller, but just maybe not that too.
2 for 173. 11 balls left in the inning. Tip-off to Tryon, it's short outside the off stump cut, over the infield backward a point, but just they have one and they'll come back for a second. Just nearly getting a sunburnt roof of the mouth that time with Laomi, a backward point. Not much you could do about it. She chased it vigorously though and keeps it to 2. The Tryon moves to 11. So that averages up to 175, 2 for 175 in 19.
Tell you what, boy, there were three players that chased after that ball. They didn't see that.
I like the enthusiasm. Getting a full toss, sweeps it high, and over the rope again. Another six for Chloe Tryon. She's adding some late luster. South Africa now move along to 2 for 181. Tryon 17 off 7. 9 balls to come in the inning.
Here she comes, Rory. Here she comes. My 195 looking pretty good.
Yeah.
Yours looking
no,
not
I was
so
just
good.
Offering the over-unders. I might have got over 2, to be perfectly honest. 200 might be in serious danger here.
Could be 2 if they keep going the way they're going.
Will be the highest score of the tournament, surpassing Australia's innings against Bangladesh last night. Tip off to Tryon, short, outside the off stump. Clubbed away in the air over cover, and that'll race away for another 4. Too easy for Chloe Tryon. She's 21 off 8. 2 for 185 in the 19th, and it looks like they can score a boundary at will every ball.
It's too much width and just that length. You wonder physically how this team and mentally how this Thailand team's going. We know they've always got smiles on their faces, and I'm sure they will again today. But yeah, just I'm sure it's probably very frustrating.
All of a sudden, they played with 50 England in South Africa in the space of a week. As now Tryon going down the ground, a long on, and she's caught no drops. Put to the ground that time by Soraya Latte. And they run through for a single. It should have been a wicket. Tryon 22, 186 for 2. And for the first time in the 3 games, the Thai fielding really showing some cracks, because up until today, they've been very good. Today, they have not.
Probably quite a simple catch then. She just found herself on the run.
Tipok into Sune Luus, whips this wristily away towards deep square leg, but there's a fielder there. So they'll get just the one run. The return comes in on that occasion from Boochatham. But a very productive over. 2 for 187 South Africa, or 186, 2 for 187, Noah's right. So 20 runs off the over, off the 19th. Sune Luus is not out 59, Chloe Tryon is not out 22. And how many, how greedy is South Africa going to be in this final over of the year?
I think they'll be wanting 200. I think it is a good thing. Just never knowing this competition too. run rate could play a part in it if there's some more upsets along the way. So I think, you know, keep winning your games, yes, but the more you can get your run rate up in this game too, I'm sure that's what they'll be after.
So it's going to be Satourawang to finish. And Skip said, I've got good news for you and bad news. The good news is bowling, the bad news is to hammer everything wrong.
I don't think she could, you know, it's just maybe an opportunity for her to bounce back.
Satourawang bowls very short, clubbed away by Luus towards deep mid-wicket. They'll try for two. Tryon's coming back to the danger end. The throw is on its way. And it hit the stump. That was a great throw by Chaiwai, but safely aimed at Chloe Tryon. So they get two runs, but a great bit of fielding. Luus 61 off 40. 2 for 189. Five balls to come. I just saw the score predictor come up on the monitor for whatever that's worth. And that had 195.
There you go. So, you know. Well, they looked at it this morning. They think they're not here, are they?
No, they haven't gone. They're just showing a replay. They haven't gone upstairs. Satourawang.
Close. Very close.
Satourawang it is. Sune Luus looks right across the stump. Hit on the pad, well outside off, and it trickles to short third, and they end up taking what will be a leg bye. Yeah, it is a leg bye. 2 for 190, four balls to come of South Africa's innings. Can they become the first team in this 2020 T20 World Cup to score 200?
Yeah, she started off well here. There's no boundaries being scored off the first two balls, Maury. That's a positive.
So now Satourawang facing Chloe Tryon, who's clubbed 22 off 9. She waits. Slower ball. Club down the ground towards long on. It should be cut off. It is, and they'll keep it to 1. Now they're coming back for a second on the throw. Struggling to get back, but getting back nonetheless is Sune Luus. It wasn't the best return of all time from Saraya Latte. And they scramble through for 2. 192 for 2. Three balls to come in the South African inning.
But they've been taking these two points, Maury. They haven't run twos all day, and they've back-to-back.
You know why they haven't? Because Lizelle Lee was back.
She's been hitting fours and sixes.
Don't worry about two. Try on 24 off 10. Satourawang bowls. Boulder! She went for a big shot in the cow corner and hits middle and off. So she's standing her ground. You've got to go, Chloe. And she touched the bat under her arm and off she goes. That's one of those ones that Alex Darby is a career goal to review a clean bowl like that.
Well, no, she never gets out for it.
True.
Telling lies.
No, she said that publicly on the wires. Among many other things, that that's a challenge in life, is to have the opportunity to send one upstairs. Tryon on away. Bowled by Satourawang for 24 of 11 deliveries. 1-4, 2-6s, 3 for 192. Two balls to come. And a nice result for Satourawang.
Yeah, exactly. And there's only been 5 runs scored on 4 balls. 3 wickets down now. So, you know, this is a really good, you know, it's really good last over for Thailand. Maybe they can go with a little bit of momentum.
And they won't have Sune Luus on strike for the, at least for one of the last two balls, which is good news for them.
True, but when you've got the class of the Preez coming out, she can go straight away. She's what, this is the 101, 101 run down, so 101.
Join the club. 3 for 192. There's only two balls to come, and it will be Mignon to Preez on strike. She's just having a look around the field. She had a really good WBBL season for the Melbourne Stars. It is her 101th game for South Africa. Average of only 21.8. Strike rate of 100. Satourawang bowls and Mignon de Preez pulls it uppishly towards deep mid-wicket. They have one and they're coming back for the second. Throwing its way to the strikers and all they she took forever to get the bales off Satourawang. And as a result, Sune Luus makes it back. That was a run out by about 3 metres, but for some reason it took Satourawang forever to get the ball onto the bales.
I have my finger up. Finger was up.
Well, she's
she missed the first one.
She's had an air sweep. One ball to come. 3 for 194. Can Mignon de Preez remember the second ball she faced? Hit it over the boundary for a 6 to bring up 200 for South Africa. Will they get a single and make Joanne Brogdy Broadbent a genius?
Come on, Thailand.
It's all about me. Here comes Satourawang. Bowls for the Preez. She gets an inside edge on the pad. Down to short third man. They only get a run. And Joe Broadbent celebrating like she's just won Wimbledon. Preez, even allowing for the fact that Dane Barnaker really gave a wicket away early on with a wrathful cross and just scooped to Chantam at mid-on. From that point on, it was all South Africa going according to the form. Preez at 195, a very imposing total, with Lizelle Lee getting the century, the star of the day.
Yeah, definitely, like, you know, what a brilliant innings, and it was a little bit of a, you know, slowish start in what we've seen from South Africa before, but, you know, they didn't sort of really, minor hiccup really when you think about it, and the partnership between Sune, Luus and Lizelle Lee was just set it up well for them. You know, they're probably a bit unfortunate not to get the 200 in the end, with Chloe Tryon coming in there and smashing 24 off 11 balls. What a brilliant innings. That's what you want from someone coming in the last two or three overs of a game.
Run the rule over the Thailand bowling and fielding today. Wasn't quite up to what we've seen the first couple of games, was it?
Yeah, it was really up and down. I think, you know, when they're good, they're really good, and when they're not, you know, it looks... And look, they would be disappointed with that, I'm sure. Their coaching staff will review all that, and it's just about individuals, yeah, doing more in the fielding component, in particular their catching and their ground fielding. And, you know, I know that they spend a lot of time together as a team, Thailand, and they're quite a tight unit, and they actually all sort of live together in Thailand and do their training, and it's really well set up. It's just a matter of, I think, time, you know, when they continue, they're playing more games than they ever have before. I think the more games, the more trainings that they can get in and work together, the better they're going to be.
Is it fair to say what I mentioned late in that innings, that as much mentally as physically, the fact that all of a sudden they've had to lift against these opponents that they so admire, where Cindy, England and now South Africa are in a really cool space of time?
Yeah, and you know, every time you see the Thailand team, whether it's media or you're at games or you're watching them on the field, they've just got the world's biggest smile on their face, and I think, you know, they've done a lot of hard work, and their organisation, you know, well done to Thailand Cricket, who have really sort of supported their women's team and put a lot of funding into it and support staff, and, you know, they've done, you know, a great effort in the qualifiers to win, you know, lots of games, and, you know, just, it'll pay dividends for them. It's just something, you know, like you've got brushing your teeth every day, Maury, you don't realise until, you know, maybe a week later it's doing well. If you don't brush them, not so good.
A battle I constantly have with at least one of my children. The call of the card. South Africa 3 for 195, having won the toss and elected to bat first. Dane Barnaker was caught by Chantam and hit on off pending last of 2. It was 1 for 13 in the third over. Lizelle Lee caught and bowled by Laomi for 101 off 60 deliveries, 16 fours, 3 sixes, and she was out at 2 for 144 in the 16th over, having shared a wonderful partnership of 131 with Sune Luus. Chloe Tryon came in after that and whacked it around, as Joe Broadbent just mentioned before. She was bowled by Satura Wang in the last over for 24 off 11 balls, 1 4, 2 sixes. It was 3 for 192. Sune Luus finishes 61 not out, coming in at number 3 today at the early fall of the wicket. 61 not out off 41 balls, 5 fours and 2 sixes. And Mignon Preez not out 3 from 2 deliveries. 4 extras from 2 wides, 1 no ball and 1 leg bye. The total finishes at 3 for 195. Now, the bowling figures for Thailand, not pretty reading. Nattaya Boochatham, 3 overs none for 37. Saraya Latte, 2 overs none for 17. Ratpong Patlaird, Ham Chinnapol, 4 overs, 3 overs 1 for 19. Cameron Tibbock, the captain, 3 overs for 36. Silipon Laomi, 4 overs 1 for 39. Janita Sutarang, 3 overs 1 for 32. And Monika Kantapu, 2 overs, none for 14. So it will be an imposing chase for Thailand, who have struggled to get beyond 8 so far in their 2 games of this World Cup. And they're facing 196 runs to win here at Manuka Oval. So, a great performance by South Africa, led by Lizelle Lee's 101. We'll be back in the second inning shortly, or the run today shortly. But here are the highlights of a wonderful performance by South Africa against Thailand.
The Women's T20 World Cup.
The Boochatham with a slip is great. Chaiwai with a slip. And the first ball is reached by a defensive stroke by Lizelle. Thailand as Boochatham bowls, and Lizelle goes on the sweep, and she gets it back with a square for a boundary. As Boochatham bowls to Lizelle, who's on the sweep over the top this time, a backward square and another boundary. And now it's a full toss to Walkby, wing it out! The catch has been taken very comfortably by Chantam, I think you'll find. And South Africa is 1 for 13 in the third over. She starts into Lizelle Lee, who goes over the top of mid-off. That'll go one bounce, two bounces over the rope for four.
Luus waits. He's outside the off-stump, chopped hard away through the covers. That's going to run to the ropes. It does. Comes in and falls. This is walloped hard by Lizelle Lee into the leg side. It's going to be four more runs. I think it is. Yep. Sitarang is bowling. It's driven hard by Lee, and it beats mid-off, and it's going to be four more. That's the 50 up for South Africa. It's driven hard. Almost a catch. Should have been a catch. Straight back to the bowler. It's been put down. Sitarang. Ooh, full toss. Horrible delivery. It's hooked away, and it's going to be hooked for six, and I wouldn't be surprised if that was signaled as a no ball as well.
Sitarang.
Ball to Sune Luus. Free hit. Drop back of the length, and it's hit brutally as far as mid-off. Oh, could be a run out. Oh, but it hit it, would have been.
Sitarang.
Bowling to Lizelle Lee. That's going to be the half century, and it's brought up with a six. Straight down the ground, thunders into the advertising hoardings on the full.
This one's dragged back the length, and there's a dive from the fielder, but it's pierced the gap, and it's all the way through to the deep point boundary for four. And she's driven firmly exactly where she hit the last boundary. This time, it's all the way along the ground and bounces over the rope. Another four for Lizelle Lee, South Africa. 103 for one. That brings up 100 in style. She bowls, and this time it is heaved over deep mid-wicket by Lizelle Lee. Absolutely swatted that one for six. Lizelle Lee waits. They only bowled, and she drives that beautifully through the covers. The dive and tip off nowhere near it. Another boundary.
Lands off well short, pulled away by Lizelle Lee. That may race away for four. Coming around desperately was Chaiwai, but it beats her to the boundary rope. 97 Lizelle Lee. As Lizelle Lee goes on the sweep, it goes back with a square. It's going to go for four, and that's going to be 100. It is. For the first time in South African colours in T20 cricket, Lizelle Lee gets a century. 101 for 59 deliveries. South Africa 1 for 144. She scored 101 out of 144. The 100 for 59 deliveries. 16 fours and 3 sixes. She waits for Leone to finish the over, and she pushes it back to the bowler and is out. She made the century and lost concentration. Caught and bowled by Leone from the last ball of her four overs. She finishes with 1 for 39. Lizelle Lee's wonderful knock comes to an end. Caught and bowled for 101. Who is sweeping powerfully between deep square leg and short fine leg for another four. That raced away. Two for 150. Luus on 48. Waits, and this is a well-flighted full toss. Hammered over square leg for six, and Sune Luus brings up a half century for South Africa. That was a ranked full toss. Tip-off now bowls a full toss. Tryon goes squares high, long six. The Turawang bowls. Boulder. She went for a big shot in the cow corner and it hits middle and off. It's all about him. Here comes the Turawang. Bowls to the Preez. She gets an inside edge on the pad. Down the short third man. They only get a run. And Joe Broadbent celebrating like she's just won Wimbledon. South Africa finishes at 20 overs at 3 for 195.
The Women's T20 World Cup on ABC Grandstand and BBC 5 Live Sports Extra. Jai Courtney.
Family, anyone know where you are?
Immigration detention, not a prison
sentence.
Asha Kitty. We just need to keep this away from the media.
Faisal Bazi.
I am a refugee. I ask for protection.
Marcia Dusseldorf. Dominic West. And Kate Blanchett.
You found you. And you won't take that away.
Stateless. Continues Sunday on ABC TV and iView.
Full shot. Struck it nicely. Dead and deliver. And smack it for six.
The Women's T20 World Cup on ABC Grandstand and BBC 5 Live Sports Extra.
So good to have your company, and if you're listening through ABC Grandstand on digital or on the ABC Listen app and you found that T20 button and gone whack, thank you. Nice to have your company. Nice to have your company through BBC 5 Live Sports Extra. Good morning to you. It's still very early over there. What are we looking at? 5.30 in the morning. Plenty of you would be up in and about. What else would you want to be doing at 5.30 in the morning than listening to South Africa play Thailand down in Canberra, where it's a beautiful late afternoon. The sun continues to shine. Temperatures in the mid-20s. Just perfect for cricket and perfect for South Africa, who have managed a total of 3 for 195 against Thailand, thanks to Lizelle Lee's 101. So the chase for Thailand imposing Alex Hartley, 196. If you're Thailand, they've battled at, what, 78 and 80 so far against the West Indies and England. I'd like to see them in a slightly different approach and see what they've got to offer in a more attacking vein. If they can see that they don't have big hitters and that's not part of their game yet, would they be trying something a little bit different today or not?
I don't think so. I think they'll be wanting to get up to 100. How good would it be to see one of the opening batters still there at 20 overs, 50, 60 not out?
That's going to be hard, but we saw Chantam the other day about it really well against him at 30 odd. But because she hasn't been in that position against that sort of attack, she ran out of puff probably more mentally than physically at around about the 10 over mark.
Yeah, it does get tough. You know, cricket's a mental tough game, especially when you're facing, you know, world's best bowlers. South Africa will come out. They'll really want to roll Thailand here because run rate's really important to see who's going to finish top of the table. I think South Africa's run rate isn't that great at the minute. It's just above plus zero, whereas England is 2.2. So if they can have an over 100 run win here, that's going to be massive.
That'll certainly be what they're aiming for. Joe Broadbent, you've spent some time with the Thai cricketers. What do you think their approach would be, knowing that they can't score 196 in South Africa? So how will they go about it?
Yeah, I agree with Alex there. I think they'll stay true to how they've been preparing, but they will be wanting to reach that 100 mark, I think, as a group, and it'll probably have to come from the top three. They're stylish batters. They're not powerful batters, but what they're really good at is manipulating the field and being able to, you know, run between wickets really quickly. So, you know, hopefully they can just continue to improve, whether it's in the field, in their bowling, and obviously in their batting as well.
And if you're the South African bowlers, Mary Van Camp not playing today, she's crook, not injured, just unwell, including just done her funny shirt. She would know that Mary Van Camp does before. What's their attitude? Do they want to try and wipe them out and score the overs and win easily, or have they got a plan they're going to stick to and just be disciplined?
I mean, why would you not want to win in 12 overs? I think every game of cricket you want to win as quick as possible. Get yourself home, get your feet up. They've got a World Cup to try and win.
Yep.
Yeah, I think they'll play some attacking cricket here. Well, I hope we do see attacking cricket. I'm sure we will. I think they'll pepper the stumps and it'll be a little bit of you miss, we hit plan of attack, I think.
I know that we saw in the England game, England went quite defensive with Thailand, had their four fielders out straight away, and I thought that was because they were trying to practice bowling at the better teams. However, word from the camp was that they got a bit of a telling after that because they weren't attacking enough. They should have had the field up, they should have really put the foot on the throat and tried to win the game as quick as possible.
It's hard to give head or not. Bit of a gobble after that game.
No, I know.
108 not out, 2 overs done for 5. She pretty much did her bit.
But new coach, Lisa Cartland, coming in.
Ooh, that's right, that Aussie spirit. What England needed, Alex. Thailand against England, 7 for 78 off their 20 overs. They managed 27 off the power play, and I reckon that's probably where the salary cap would be in that power play with the style of play they're having at the bowlers they've been facing. So I'm with you, it'd be great to see them get off to a good start. Try and get 30-35 in that power play, not lose a wicket, and see if they can really build it here.
Yeah, I don't see why they can't. If they know they're not the most powerful hitters of the ball, they've not got Naruemol cap bowling at them, so maybe they could try and manipulate the field a little bit more. They've run their singles really well, so they can win their ones and twos. You know, South Africa aren't the fittest team in the world, so if they can really push them with that respect, you never know, they could get 100.
Right, Joe, before you go and have a cup of tea.
Do you want me to tell me what they're going to score?
That's exactly what I was going to ask you, because at the 15-over mark, I said over under 190, you said 195, and then carried on like you'd won Wimbledon, but they got 195. So what's your prediction? What's Thailand going to end up with here?
I'm going to go 101.
I knew you'd be optimistic.
I'm going to, I don't want to go the upset, but I'll go 101. 101.
101. What you were saying that Mignon de Preez was in a 100 and... What'd you say? 101th game. Yeah. You need a breather. Thank you, Joe.
Enjoy it.
Alex Hartley, Andrew Moore with you. through ABC Grandstand and BBC 5 Live Sports Extra. Just getting started really in this double header here at Manuka Oval in Canberra. This is the fourth of five games over the last 3 days. And there's not much of a break, is there? Looking forward to heading down to Bega, about 3 hours south of here tomorrow, for the Bushfire Appeal charity rugby league game between Penrith and Parramatta. And, for listeners through the ABC, we'll be calling that from 3:30 p.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Time. And then coming back here tomorrow night, off to Sydney for another doubleheader on Monday. Rather on Sunday. Can't remember what day it is. But on Monday, that's the game in Group A, Australia and New Zealand and Melbourne. That's going to be fantastic.
Quarterfinals, basically, isn't it?
100%, yeah. So it's going to be Mlaba, the 19-year-old, left arm finger spinner to open the bowling for South Africa. She'll be bowling from that pool then. So she's only 19. It's only a 7th T20 game. And yet to take the wicket, conceding 125 runs at an economy rate of almost 9. She did take 1 for 19 against Australia in one of the World Cup warm-up games. Played twice in the series against New Zealand in January and was wicketless there. See how she goes against Boochatham and Chantam opening the batting for the Thailand. Let's hope they get a good start.
Let's hope they do. We saw Thailand was pretty comfortable against England teams the other day, so it's not a bad option going spin here.
Especially with no cap. So here we go. Thailand needing 196 to win. And Nonkululeko Mlaba opens the bowling. Left arm spinner. And she's in, and it's pulled away by Chandon towards mid-wicket. Drops! That was a sitter that's been put down by Ismail. Continuing these high catches that have been put down at a very regular rate in this World Cup. And a let off for Chandon. She's off the mark. So is Thailand. But they should have been one for none, except they're none for one.
Absolutely fuming with that.
Now the left-hander on strike, Boochatham. One run and without loss. Boochatham plays it nicely through the covers, albeit a diving stop will prevent more than one run. And one run it will be. So two without loss, Thailand. As that fielding was done by Lara Wolvaardt. Lost all the sound effects there.
My hearing's gone.
That's what I was worried about. I'm older than you. It's a real chance for me. Mlaba in, going to Chantam. Pushes it back to the bowler this time, and no run after she had that life in the very first ball.
That was bizarre, wasn't it? I thought.
Then the sound went out again. I thought I'm 50 on done. She finished. Mlaba fights it, defended by Chantam towards the covers. No run. Nunnapat picks up. Now we get the two Thailand in the first over. Mlaba bowls to Chantam. Goes back. Pushes it into the covers again. Again, there's no run. Ismail is very quick. She bowled really well for Sydney Thunder in the WBBL. Skids off the wicket. She's got the catch. First ball. Mlaba into Chantam, who's pushing it relentlessly back down the pitch. And a nice over to Mlaba. Two runs off, and Thailand no gets the two needing 196 to win. Chantam one, Boochatham one.
That's only going to make Ismail angry with that drop catch. She's going to come in now, and no doubt both of them. She'll run it hard. And I think we can see some short ball in here after that drop catch.
Yes, well, she's heading with purpose towards our end, the Manuka end of the ground. Shabnim Ismail, 31-year-old from Cape Town. And the 90th T20 game, 95 wickets at 18.96 in a run, an economy rate of under 6 and over. Best bowling of 5 for 30. She took 1 for 26 against England. Didn't have a really productive series in January in New Zealand against New Zealand with the Silver Fern. So none for 2 Thailand, but she can bowl quick, and I just say she's not going to try and get it up around their chins out of frustration. She can be really skiddy off the pitch and cause the top order some problems.
Yeah, we can see with this field here that South Africa have gone very aggressive. They've got a slip, a gully, back good point, cover, extra cover, mid-off. And the mid-off has gone real, real close, saving the one.
Yeah, the mid-off, Chloe Tryon. So on the onside, there's a whitish mid-on and a fine leg. So we've got 7-2 field. Here comes Ismail. bowling to Boochatham. It goes the slog and gets an inside edge down the fine leg. I tell you what, Ayabonga, they have changed their game plan. Boochatham is two, Thailand none for three. They're going to try and back themselves in the power play.
Well, the first ball, it looks like it comes off the bat. I don't blame him at all. Should have got hold of that. He's gone absolutely miles.
Yeah, that was heading into the city if you got hold of it. But she did, but she gets a run. Now Chantam takes the strike. Ismail all the way back to the 25-metre circle to start her approach. A slip, a gully. Backward point and a point, cover and a mid-off on the onside. Straight as she been wicked inside the circle and deep backward square. Ishmael bowls from Chantam and she pulls this one. It's not off the middle, but it runs down to deep backward square. And there is a run to be had. Fielding is done right down there on the boundary by Khaka. And it's no good for four in the second over. And Chantam needs to move. What was speculating on before the innings, I think it's great to see. Ishmael. She was unhappy before, she'll be even more unhappy with these two shots that have been played against her. Boochatham, the left-hander, wanted to play away on the offside, but just got a little wide from her and it goes through to the keeper. And it's taken there by Chetty, and it's a dot ball. She gave herself room to really have a crack at it, but because of that, and that the ball was outside the offside, she ran out of room, basically.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, it's a few times. Maybe there's not as much
challenge
as we thought there was.
Ishmael, Thailand, four without loss, nine balls into the chase, 196. In over the wicket. Short ball, bouncer, Boochatham ball, gets the top edge, and she's got no drops again! Chloe Tryon puts it down this time, an absolute sitter. And another dreadful catching attempt. In fact, it wasn't Tryon who dropped that, it was Nadine de Klerk, who's come in to the side for Mary's and Cap, and de Klerk drops an absolute sitter. What's going on, Alex Hart?
I mean, it was that bad, the captain just started laughing. That's how bad that drop catch was. There was nothing more she could have done than laugh at that.
The outfield catching in this World Cup, for all the good cricket we've seen, has been abysmal.
I mean, that's look how angry Ishmael is. She can't. She is fuming. Her hands are on her hips.
Well, hang on, de Klerk. She's a young player, but otherwise she might say, hang on, what happened to you last day? Don't get too cranky.
That's very true, but I wouldn't be saying that to her.
No. I don't think she has either. No wickets for five, three to Boochatham. So a light for Chantam from the first ball of the innings, and now Boochatham dropped an absolute dolly at mid-off by de Klerk when she was on two. Thailand none for five. It could have been two for one. So Ismail, hands on hips, first lift. Ready to steam in again. I'm not sure I'd want to be chanted here. And there's been a bit of a delay with gloves. Shoelaces being done up. Here she comes to the right-handed chanter. He comes down the track and pulls it. Gets it very, very fine. Deep backwards square. Khaka on her way. Dives. And I don't think she prevents it going for four. And it's leg five. With the call from the umpire, Jack Williams. And it is a four. So Thailand moved to nine. So came off the hip of Chantam. And more frustration for Ismail. Now we get to the ninth over.
I always laugh when I find the ball.
Because it didn't go against you.
Like,
you're all about team, aren't you?
I'd
be
like, oh, never mind. Don't make me look
Don't
bad.
Worry me. Still got none for one. Sweet. Ismail, who has none for three, comes into Chantam, dances down the track, lines in between slip and gully. Third man had an impossible task and it's four runs. Great stuff. Thailand backing themselves. Yes, they've had some luck with two horrendous drop catches by South Africa, but they find themselves after two overs for all of that. No wickets for 13.
This is where South Africa needs to be careful, because it almost looks like they're trying too hard. I mean, we've seen two awful, awful drop catches. South Africa are going to be really annoyed about that. But it almost, you get that sense that they're trying really hard here. They just need to play their natural game. Ishmael needs to bowl.
She is Miss Cranky Pants at the moment. She's fluttering her arms about and having a bit to say as she heads out to, where's she going to be fielding the covers for the left-hander?
Yeah, even worse, she went out to the boundary and got brought back in. So
I wonder if Dane handled that. Back this way. Really quietly, I reckon. Here's Mlaba, who bowled very well with the left-arm fingers in the first over. Back for a second. Into Boochatham. She just respectfully defended square on the offside. There's no runners. De Klerk comes in and picks it up. Score 13 without lock. Chantam 6, Boochatham 3. Lizelle leads 101 to Sune, South Africa 3-195. This ball short outside the off stump, cut away to back to the point. Klerk there again, no run. Off the bowling of Mlaba. Seems too simple from her 8 deliveries. Then it'll drop that.
I think when you have a player that gets so wound up and so angry, it sometimes has a really negative effect on the rest of the team. Because I know that in the English side, Captain Brunt used to get really wound up.
Intimidated. Mlaba into Boochatham, who whips this away. An adventurous strike down towards the square leg, has one. And they won't come back for a second. So a single Boochatham, she's forward by land. Move along to 14 without loss in the third eight.
Yeah, the feedback was good. Nobody makes a thing on purpose. You know, you drop a catch, she's not doing it on purpose. And she's had to work really, really hard on controlling her inner anger and not expressing it.
Mlaba into Chantam, who's forward, pushing it back to the bowler for God's ball. But how did you find her?
She was fine by the time I started playing. You know, she got the occasional throw her arms in the air, but she was nowhere near. She's absolutely fine.
Mlaba to the right-handed Chantam. Again, she just pushes it back to the bowler. No run. That's been good stuff from Mlaba. Left arm spin, does
Niekerk? You like a bit of left arm spin?
I think she's another teenager. 19.
I've got so many in this competition that I've got.
Really? Chantam away to score 6 from 10 deliveries. Might get 6 from 11 if he only pushes it back to the bowl. A really good over by Mlaba again. One run off it. Thailand 3 overs in. No hit for 14. Chantam is 6. Boochatham is not out on 4 up 3 overs in South Africa's innings. They were 1 for 13. So Thailand is currently in
the class.
I don't think it works that way. They declare now they still might have to follow on. 196 is the target. But that's good. They're 3 overs in. They're in front. I'm not sure they have a Lizelle Lee type, though.
No, me neither.
But they're going for it. That's the good news. They're having a crack.
And I much prefer to see that in T20 teams. I say it all the time. There's nothing I find more boring than just watching a team block it out for 20 overs. I just think it's pointless. It's never going to improve you as a team.
Slip, deep third, gully, backward point, cover, mid-off. A wide-ish mid-on, really a mid-wicket and a deep fine leg. As Boochatham comes down the track, gets a bottom hit, shines and stops! There's a run-out! Chantam's run-out brilliantly by the keeper, Cherry, for 6. Thailand will be 1 for 14, although we're going to the third umpire, Trisha Chetty. Moving to her right, the keeper throws down the stumps at the striker's end, and Chantam knows that she's her luck's come to an end right there.
Yeah, she might as well walk off, I don't know. That's about what you can get.
She's going to be out here by, I reckon, 2 feet. No, I'm wrong. By 4 or 5 feet. She's well out. Greg Brathwaite only needs to look at that once, surely. So Chantam will be out, run out. Funny, isn't it, the way that they've risked everything, it comes from a run out taking a single with a keeper.
I mean, it was a wonderful throw. Quite often keepers get a bit of stick for the old keeper arm, don't they? But that was wonderful.
Cherry, got it done. The run out for 6 of 11 deliveries. Nattakan Chantam. It was an enterprising but short stay. And Thailand does lose its first wicket. So they've been throwing caution to the wind. But the wind caught up with them there. One boundary in the inning for Chantam. Ball's over. 1 for 14. So South Africa does strike. Although in a way probably not that they would have anticipated with 2 drop catches so far. Koncharoenkai comes to the crease now for Thailand. She's out for a first ball duck the other night, wasn't she, against England?
Yep.
And she will be on strike with Boochatham at the other end. Koncharoenkai, can she muster up here? She batted very well, didn't she, against the West Indies, made 33. And then now she made 12 off 21 against England.
Koncharoenkai. Yeah, I thought you knew your stuff.
You should know me by now. Might have been Boochatham who got the first ball duck, it was, against England. Here's Ismail. Bowled, and Koncharoenkai is bowled! There's your first ball duck! Sorry to do it to you, Koncharoenkai, she's out! Bowled by Ismail! For a first baller, and Thailand is 2 for 14.
She just looked far too quick for her there, didn't she? She didn't move her feet, she kind of jumped out the way of the ball, and I think it actually hit middle of leg here.
Koncharoenkai gone. She played all over that, didn't she?
Yeah, far, far too quick for her. That's all Ismail needs to do here, to just ball pulling straight, ball as fast as you can.
though. And none for 14. It was a fun start to the innings, wasn't it? The two drop catches, but they're having a crack. And now all of a sudden it looks rather jiggly at 14 for 2.
Yeah.
Especially when you look up and think, oh, the chance of number 96, that's not a good start.
Let's just say we're chasing 100. Let's go for that. Yes. I think they need to say, right, let's get to the 80 again. Oh, 78, is it that's been out? Oh,
78 and 80. Yeah,
yeah, so we're going to get to 80, 85, 90. But, I mean, Ismail might fall four straight through here.
Now, Yumor Chaiwai is next out for Thailand. And she comes in with South Africa all of a sudden with their tails up. And 14 for 2. That's from the 29-year-old Chaiwai. And a 38 for T20. Batting average of around about 20. 13 against the West Indies. 19 not out of 23 against England. Now there's two slips in play. Here's Ismail. Bowled. Chaiwai's bowled! First ball. Team hat-trick. Alex Hartley's guessed correctly. Chaiwai goes for a golden. And Thailand is 14 for 3. Midway through the first over. And now Shabnim Ismail is on a hat-trick herself.
I don't think she's cracked a smile yet, though, either. She should be pleased about that. There's two fantastic balls. Full straight. Fast. It just looks far too fast for the Thailand batters here. There's no foot movement whatsoever. She's played right across that ball. Oh, you can see the stumps. Stumps are out the ground.
That's
very well bowled.
Great sight for a fast bowler. So 3 wickets in 3 balls. We had Chantam run out by the keeper, Cherry, for 6. Koncharoenkai bowled by Ismail for a first ball duck. And the next ball, Chaiwai bowled for a first ball duck by Ismail.
I reckon everyone else should get their pads on here.
I reckon they
everybody
might.
Everybody get padded on.
I don't think there's many pads left lying around in the kit bag. So now the skipper's coming, tip-off. Summer in tip-off. Well, why not? If you're up against a hat-trick and your team's falling apart.
I'd love this field.
So we've got two slips, a deep third, a gully, a point, an extra cover, a mid-wicket in a catching position and a deep fine leg. So it's a 7-2 field. And the cover is only about 15 metres from the back. Hat-trick delivery. Tip off on throw. Oh, Ismail nearly caught one in the melon from the umpire. Declan Williams said, hold your horses, and nearly eye-gouged that.
Tip off in her face. Ismail's going to be fuming.
Zipok's laughing because she's got another 30 seconds, perhaps.
I reckon we're waiting for the good old TV. There we go.
So now umpire Williams says, away you go. Ismail on a hat-trick. Here she comes, bowls to Zipok, and it's cut away to the gully on the ground. No run, no hat-trick, 14 for 3, and the crowd supporting Thailand cheer.
Boring.
We all wanted to have
to be
honest. Ismail is 2 for 7 in the second over, but equally happy to tip off survive that hat-trick delivery. Boochatham at the other end is thinking, why did Chantam call me through for that run? We were flying. Now
Captain,
she's watched carnage.
Captain's knock is needed here.
Ismail around the wicket. 14 for 3. She bowls to Tipok and it's worked away off her pads into the vacant square leg position. She has one and will have to be content with one as the fielding's done by de Klerk. So Tipok off the mark and Thailand finally off the dreaded 14. They're now 15 for 3. One ball to come in the fourth over.
What's Ismail going to do here? I think she's pulled straight. And the stumps are just outside off trying to get that catch a slip.
Well, I hope Boochatham doesn't go into a shell. I know she's only 4 or 8, but she's had great intent out there. Let's keep it going. Ismail bowls through. She comes down the track and defends it away square on the offside. And there's no run, but there was again purpose to all of that. What a great over by Chetty Ismail. 2 overs, 2 for 8. 3 wickets, 4 in the innings as Thailand slumped to be 3 for 15, chasing 196 for victory with Boochatham on 4 and Tipok the captain on 1.
Brilliant bowls.
There was seem to be a bit of weird action when we're on together. It just seemed like the start of the innings just left Australia when the Bangladesh captain was armed but I don't know how to fly off the body.
Still
not either. No, I'm not either.
I was
sleep last night.
You beat me to it.
So Mlaba will bowl her third straight over. She's been a shining light. Two overs, none for three. She'll be bowling with the left-handed tip-off. Well, there's both left-handers out there now. Chantam run out six. Koncharoenkai out for a duck bowl. Ismail. Chaiwai, the same fate, first ball. Mlaba well flighted and tip-off drives it back down to the bowler and there's no run. We'll remain three for 15. 181 to win off 95 deliveries. Forward, respectfully in defense. Back down to the bowl.
Solid, very solid. You don't need solid in the T20 though. What's that time?
You mentioned the pace of Ismail. She's bowling up over I'll get back to the comment in a minute. But she's bowling over 120k an hour. Tryon wouldn't have faced that very often. Mlaba is in to tip off and she plays away on the cover. Got ball. What did you just say?
I said it's solid, but we don't need that in 2020 cricket. We want a bit of excitement.
Well, what if you're 3 for 15 and you've barely got your pads on
and number 581.
So you're saying, when in doubt, clout. Mlaba to tip off, beaten outside the off stump, taken by Cherry the keeper.
I think in all seriousness, sometimes teams can get too bogged down on the fact that they need to rebuild and get too defensive. Just play your natural game, the runs will come. If you they're not going to win this game. If you lose wickets, so what?
Mlaba to tip off, who's forward, defending, back down the bowl. Alex Hartley shakes her head.
If they do this for 20 hours, I'm not coming back.
Deal. I'm with you at the pub. Here's Mlaba. Last ball of the fifth over. Bowling tip-off is 1 from 7. And she tucks this off her hip. She's now 1 from 8. Gee, I reckon there was a run there, but Boochatham said, no. I'm going to take the strike. 3 overs are made, none to 3, Mlaba. That was the maiden. 5 overs gone. Needing 196 to win, Thailand is 15 for 3. Boochatham 4, tip-off is 1. And now to join the ever-increasingly frustrated Alex Hartley will be Melinda Pat.
ABC Grandstand's coverage of the cricket. The Women's T20 World Cup. On ABC Grandstand and BBC 5 Live Sports Extra.
when you're bowling at the tail, quite often or not, you just need to bowl your stop ball, ball full and straight. But I think it's a great opportunity for her to practice bowling at the death, pretend it's a death over.
Luus. Bowl. Well pitched up. Club down towards long on and falls just short of the Klerk. And on the double take the single. So one more run for Thailand. Previous shouts, but we are going to the third umpire, Greg Brathwaite, 8 for 73 at the moment. 78 has been the score they've come up with twice so far. She was out of a crease. Chetty from outside off comes back, foot coming back. Oh, now it's on the line, but is it over? Oh, gee, maybe by a putteenth.
Does the line go to the field?
The line is out. Maybe a bit of a shoe just on the inside the crease. I reckon it will be not out.
Don't look at it for a good 5 minutes.
There's a millimetre in it. Now, if you were the bowler, you could say it's not out.
We had one of those in the 2017 World Cup final, and I was keen to close out.
So, that answers the question perfectly. Is that even close or what's happening?
I think the arm was in it. I get a bit close.
Yeah, I don't think that's perfect.
No, I couldn't see, so I had to move a little bit more.
So not out of the court. She just got maybe one cleat back inside the crease. So Naomi waiting for Luus, who rocks back, pulls and gets the top edge. She's going to be caught at mid-wicket by Niekerk, and she's on her way. So Luus had to wait another delivery, but she gets the wicket. Naomi out. Caught Niekerk, bowled by Luus for three. Thailand 9 for 73. And Luus at the end of the four overs at 3 for 15.
Well, very, very well. She had a cracking day. I mean, if Sune had dropped that catch then, I think everyone would have been...
Everyone was going home.
Yeah, everyone's going home. It's been a strange World Cup for drop catches, because we've seen some phenomenal fielding and we've seen some dreadful fielding at the same time.
Yeah, the catches were great. And like I was saying before, again, watching a lot of the last two seasons of WBBL, fielding standard is outstanding. So this has been a real shock to see this happening around the country so far.
I don't know why that happens. It's almost like one team starts dropping catches and it catches on. It's contagious.
So 9 for 73. Can Thailand match their previous two scores? They need another 5. That seems a bit away. As Saraya Latte comes in at number 11 for Thailand. See what pedigree she has with the bat. Can't be all that much. I'm prepared to say she's coming in at number 11, a 20-year-old. In fact, she hasn't batted prior to this World Cup.
Ever? Wow. Yeah.
Well, not in T20. Sure, she's batted somewhere at some time.
Yeah, they don't let her practice.
No. Well, maybe she got the same instructions as you outrageous as what was the case. Staying home and blocking only sweep, nothing else.
I mean, if in doubt, sweep, that was my mum's job. I used to sweep everything.
Especially when that was the only effect that you're allowed to block. All right, the 19th over begins. South Africa on their way to a heavy win, and it's Nadine Vanderclark. That's a full toss. That should be a wide or a no ball, at least, for being waist high. It's cut away for a couple of runs, and it's coming back for two now. So Thailand 9 for 76. The two runs plus the no ball. Three from the delivery. And it'll be a free hit.
They're getting closer.
Latte off the mark with a couple, and she'll get the free hit. Yeah, that was very close to the Roman Reeves. She cut it away for a couple.
That's going to be her first warning.
9 for 76. Could she whack a boundary here and get them to their top score of the World Cup? Around the wicket comes Nadine de Klerk, who came in for Mary's Ann Tapp, who was unwell. And Latte plays it away on the offside. The cover, but there's no run as Ismail fields it. And must frankly pretend to shy at the stumps. He holds on to the white bill. Score of 76 for 9.
Come on, girl. We're one away from this.
Marte, in the Alex Hartley batting position, comes forward, drives it. Diving attempt by the bowler, the clerk, to cut it off. He's unsuccessful, and Tryon comes around. Dropping it off the field. They do get a run. 9 for 77. Can't happen for the third game. Nadine de Klerk. So there's a deep third. There's a backward point cover, mid-off, all inside the circle. A mid-on, mid-wicket, and a deep mid-wicket. There's a deep square and a deep fine leg. So Pandingland. 10 balls left in the game. South Africa hoping it's one. Pandingland gives herself some room. Lofts it over mid-off. They're going to best it, all right. You little ripper. Pandingland moves to six. Thailand goes past 80 for the first time. 81 for 9 in the 19th over. Well done, Thailand.
That was a proper, proper cricket shot. Lofted it over mid-off. That was beautiful. Get her up the order.
Can't be hard to win a promotion based on what we've seen. Pandingland doing her best. Well done. 6 off 3. You're right, that was a fair decision. Lofted drive. It's big. So, Thailand up over 80 for the first time. Being bowled a slower ball and it's carved away wide and mid off. No, it's diving save. Prevents it being any more than a run by Luus. Not going to get much past Sune today. And then Glover 7. 9 for 82. Two balls to come to 19th over. And so in the first ever inning, is 3 not out from 3 deliveries. Goes to the keeper. Chetty takes it behind the stumps. 82 for 9.
That was a big swing.
We gave herself a cold there. Oh, she swung in the wind from the windy walk.
Oh, wow.
Nadine around the wicket. Latte goes powerfully on the offside to cover. Shy the stumps from Ismail. The batter was sent back. And well, it's a good throw. Well, Latte thinks he's run out by Ismail. And that'll be all she wrote. So we're going to the third umpire, but a bit like the end of the Australian innings yesterday when Bangladesh went for an appeal to the third umpire. All the players have said that's enough. Or do they not know it's only the 19th over?
I didn't think that was out. I think they've got confused.
Now they're coming back. They're running back. But we're watching the replay. Chetty for the stumps. Just in. Just in. Just in, I think. You with me?
Yeah, just in.
Okay.
Just in Timberlake.
So, the batters, I honestly think they thought that was the end of the game.
They must have done.
I don't think it was because she thought she'd run out as much as they thought that was the end of it. So, it will be 82 for 9. Has she got any of the bat over? You can't give it out. Don't give it out. One more over. So, here we go. Decision pending. It'll be not out. We'll get one more over. There you go. Not out. 82 for 9. Everyone cheers, often. This is a team getting beat by an over 110. The people are cheering everything. Fantastic. So one over to come. And it will be... Oh,
I'll tell you what.
The bad news is Thailand. She's got Ismail. She's bowling to Pandingland. Gives herself some room. Clean bowled. And that's all she wrote. Thailand bowled out for 82. Relatively constant delivery from Ismail at 111. Pandingland though, bowled for 8 by Ismail, who finishes with 3 for 8. And South Africa wins this game by 113 runs at Nattaya Oval. And they head to the top of Group B, the first team to 4 points. Either England or